Aparna, and I'm a PhD student at the e-learning lab. I'm basically from India and I come from a southern state called Kerala. I have a master's in business administration and I have 2.5 years of experience working as a business development executive for a software company called Nams Infosystems in Bangalore. My research is basically about ICT for development, and my focus is on internet usage among women users. Why I have chosen internet as an ICT tool? Because internet is so immensely used in our everyday life that we often take it for granted. Internet brings information at our fingertips and it has become more of a requisite than a luxury. My interest is arises from the fact that there are a lot of studies which have shown that women are less intensive users of internet technologies in developing countries, and women always lag behind men in adapting to these internet technologies. Now there are a lot of factors which makes a woman less intensive users of internet, like socio-cultural factors, technophobia, or the perception of it being a masculine technology. There are time constraints imposed by role responsibilities. So what I'm interested is to find out what exactly keeps a woman away from internet, and can they really be empowered through internet usage if they are given proper training and guidance. I have done with my empirical studies, and my empirical studies was done at Department of Women's Studies at University of Calicut in Kerala. For the empirical studies, I chose a group of female students comprising of 13, and all these students were given internet training based on Bloom's digital taxonomy of learning domains. Now the methodology which I followed was emancipatory action research, which aims at individual and collective empowerment of the research. The action research workshops were based on action research model for reflective internet searching developed by Sylvia Edwards and Christine Bruce. The reason for choosing this model was because people experience internet searching and learn about internet in different ways, because often the content that is available in internet is so unstructured that how to extract the right information is often a very difficult task. So this model was used to find out how the students learn about using the internet, in which they discussed about how they planned the search and how they did the search, and how they the conclusion was based on what can be improved for searching. The main modes of data collection was through videos, audios. There were some interviews. I had given some empowerment measure questionnaires. Then I had used some artifacts, like I made them to draw, because some of the students were not very, they were often reserved and there were not much opening up, and there was a lot of observations. Based on the preliminary analysis, like based on the interviews and the feedback from the students on the knowledge level before and after the training and workshops, and based on the empowerment measure questionnaire, like based on the parameters of knowledge, fear and confidence level, it can be concluded that women do get empowered through internet usage if they are given the proper guidance and training. My idea is to develop a model for developing how and what level of training can be given to women who are less intensive users of technology. And what I suggest is that this training should be made tailor-made so that it fits into what they need exactly, depending on their background and the cultural context. And when we're talking about this empowerment research, where the empowerment is often a very difficult term to measure. So the empowerment measure should be developed depending on the context of the research and what empowerment needs for this specific research. Like for example, in this particular research, what I mean by empowerment is to make them more confident, and so that the fear is reduced and they get more knowledge. So depending on the research context, the empowerment measure should be developed accordingly.